Hi, welcome to the fourth video of the tutorial series on OrCAD. This is Shire, and in this video I'll be showing you the basics of OrCAD PSpice. I'll be using the circuit I used in the previous video. In the previous video I forgot to change the voltage value here. So to change the value, double click on it and give it a value you wish. I'll give it the value 10 volt. You can hide the value from here, or you can show both the name or name and value. You can also change the font from here and change the color from this drop down menu, or you can also change the orientation from here. I also forgot to connect the ground. You can place the ground directly on the line, or you can connect it via wire. Now to simulate, you'll need a simulation profile. Start by creating one from clicking this button over here. Give it a name and click create. You can make four types of analysis with PSpice. Use transient when you need a time dependent graph, that is a graph that has time on its x-axis. If you need to simulate the circuit to obtain a graph by changing a parameter multiple times, you need to select DC or AC sweep. DC sweep analysis is a DC voltage dependent analysis, while the AC sweep analysis is a frequency dependent analysis. If you need to determine the values of voltage, current or power dissipation on different nodes, select bias point analysis. I'll select transient for now to show how the plot window works. Click OK. On the capture window, click on this Run PSpice button here. Click on this V, I or W buttons, and it will show you the voltage on the corresponding node, or current through a device, or the power dissipated by a device. These buttons are called markers or probes. Use the voltage marker to see the voltage on a node, and use the potential difference marker to see the voltage drop across a device. You need to place the current marker on the connecting pin of the device and the power dissipation marker on the device itself. I'll use the potential difference marker for now to demonstrate. Click on it and place the markers across the device. Run PSpice and you'll see a straight line on the plot window at 10 volt. It means there's no change in the value of voltage drop across R with respect to time, since the plot has time on its x-axis. Double click on the axis and this axis settings box will appear. You can change the dotted range here to make your graph look better, although it doesn't change the simulation range. You can change the axis title from here if you need multiple y-axis. You can also make various changes to the grid options. These lines are called majors and these dotted lines are called minors. I like to hide the minor grids. You can add a trace without the help of probes from here. This button is called toggle cursor, which is especially helpful for curves. We'll discuss more about it later. One thing I like to do while simulating is to see the circuit and the plot window side by side. Windows 10 has made it easy to do this. Click and drag your capture window to the far left of the screen until you see this outline and then let go. Now Windows gives you a suggestion of the windows you can select for the other half of the screen. Click on the plot window. Also, sometimes you may need to add the graph to a document file or somewhere else for printing. Instead of taking a screenshot, cropping and then inverting colors, you can simply go to the window and select copy to clipboard and click OK. Now you can paste the graph where you want by pressing Ctrl plus V. I guess that's it for today. If I missed mentioning something or if you've got any question in your mind or have some suggestions, feel free to comment. Hit like and share with your friends. Till next time.